Good morning all. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss the topics construction, output equations and main dimensions of design of DC machines in the subject design of electrical apparatus. So in DC machine, there are three major parts: field system, armature and commutator. The field system is the stationary part of the machine and it is also outermost part of the machine. It is being stationary, it is also called stator, and it consists of main poles, inter poles, frame and yoke. The main poles are designed to produce the magnetic flux. The inter poles are placed in between them. It is to improve the process of commutation condition. And the frame is to provide the mechanical support to the machine as well as to provide the path for flux. The armature is the rotating part and inner part of the machine. It consists of armature core with slots and armature winding accommodated in the slots. The energy conversion from mechanical to electrical or vice versa takes place in the armature. The commutator is mounted on the armature of DC machine. And in case of generator, this commutator converts the induced EMF of alternating nature inside the armature into DC in the external load. In case of motor, it will convert the applied DC supply to the AC in the internal circuit of armature. Or we can say that in generator, the purpose of commutator is to convert the internally induced AC supply in the armature circuit to the DC supply in the external circuit, or unidirectional EMF in the external circuit. In case of motor, it is to produce the unidirectional torque output from the motor. And then we are going to derive the output equation of DC machine, and we can consider a single conductor of length L carrying a current of IZ amperes placed in the magnetic field with flux density B average Webers per meter square. Then the work done will be given by X B average L IZ, where X is the distance of movement of conductor through the magnetic field. And this X multiplied with L gives the area and B is the flux density. Flux density is flux per area. So flux per area multiplied with area. So this area will get cancelled, we will be getting flux. So this phi is equal to XBL. So we are replacing XBL as phi and IZ is the current through the conductor. But in actual practical machine, P number of poles will be there to produce the flux necessary for the energy conversion process, and more number of conductors, for example, Z number of conductors will be there in the DC machine. So the work done finally will be given by the product of this total magnetic loading and total electric loading. The term P phi is represented as total magnetic loading and the term IZ is represented as total electric loading. Another two terms we are going to discuss about the specific magnetic loading and specific electric loading. And specific magnetic loading is B average and it is flux per pole divided by area under a pole. Flux per pole is phi and area under the pole is, the pole is of arc like construction in a DC machine. So that pole pitch multiplied with length of armature is the area under a pole. And this pole pitch is pi d by p and the length of the armature is L. So p is taken to the numerator and so this b average is p phi divided by pi d L. And another term is specific electric loading. So it is the total armature ampere conductors divided by armature periphery at the air gap. So total armature ampere conductors is IZ is the conductor current and Z is the total number of conductors. So this is the total armature ampere conductors, and armature periphery at the air gap is, armature diameter is D. So armature periphery is the circumference of this armature outer diameter circle, and so it is 2 pi r, it is pi d. So the typical values of specific magnetic loading and specific electric loading for a DC machine, the range for B average is 0.4 to 0.8 Webers per meter square, and for AZ it is 15,000 to 50,000 ampere conductors per meter. And next is the output equation of DC machine. and it is going to be derived from the fundamental EMF induced equation in a DC machine. So the EMF equation in a DC machine is phi z n by 60 into P by A. This can also be written as phi z n into P by A, where in the first portion, first part of first equation, n or the speed of the machine is represented in RPM, and in the second part, that is with uppercase letter, and in the second equation, the n is n or the speed of the machine is represented with the small case letter n, that is n represented in RPS. So the difference between these two equations is this uppercase letter n represents the speed of the DC machine in RPM, and in the second equation, this small case letter n represents the speed of the machine in RPS. So that is the difference. And then current through each conductor is IZ. And in a DC machine, A number of parallel path will be there. So the parallel path current will be added. So this parallel path in a DC machine will depends upon whether the winding is lap winding or wave winding. This A will be equal to P, that is number of poles. In case if the machine is a lap wound machine, this A will be equal to 2 if it is a wave wound machine. So depends upon the number of parallel path in the machine, this current through the armature will be varying. This armature current is A into IZ. This can be P into IZ for a lap winding machine, 2 into IZ for a wave winding machine. And now we are going to derive the EMF, that is power developed equation of a DC machine. So power developed in the armature is always equal to induced EMF and armature current. And E into IA, okay? V into IA is the terminal voltage and terminal current. E is the induced EMF in the machine. IA is the armature current. So these two parameters are internal to the machine. So that is the initial power developed in the armature of the machine. So it is E into IA into 10 to the power minus 3 to convert it into kilowatt power. And so for E and this IA, we are going to substitute from this above equation. So for E, we are going to substitute the second equation, pi z n into P by A. And for IA, we are going to substitute this equation, A into IZ. So finally, we will be getting the equation for power developed in the armature is pi z n by P, n into P by A, and A into IZ in 10 to the power minus 3. So here, we are going to separate these two terms, that is total magnetic loading and total electric loading. And this number of parallel path in both numerator and denominator will get cancelled with each other, and the remaining term is n into 10 to the power minus 3. And so we are going to substitute for total magnetic loading and total electric loading from the specific magnetic loading and specific electric loading equation. So P phi is pi d n into V average, and IZ is equal to pi d into AC. So that two parts we are substituting here and separating out the terms. So here it is pi square. And d square l is another term, and n is separately kept away. And another two terms are b average into ac. So this first part of this equation, that is pi square b average ac into 10 to the power minus 3, is considered as c naught, and it is also the output coefficient of the machine. And the remaining terms are d square l into n. So this output equation pa, or it is also called power developed in armature, pa is equal to c naught d square l into n. So our next objective is to find out the main dimensions of the armature. So main dimensions of the armature includes this diameter and the axial length of the armature. So the D and L have to be found out from this power developed in the armature equation. And another point we can understand from this output equation is, so this D square into L is the volume of active part of the machine, because this armature is the rotating part of the machine. And so this is the volume of active part of the machine, which takes place in the energy conversion process. And so this PA, suppose if we consider the C naught, this output coefficient, as a constant parameter, this PA will be proportional to volume of active part of the machine D square L and speed of the machine L. Or suppose if we consider the C naught as a variable, then the C naught in turn will be proportional to this B average and AC, so that the output equation now will be proportional to B average, AC, and volume of active parts and speed of the machine. So this is one form of output equation of a DC machine in the perspective of design aspects. And so this is the first equation, which is PA is equal to C naught B square L into L. And from this output equation only, we will be separating out this D square L term first, and then in D square L, we will be separating this B and L. That is the main dimension of armature, okay? So the first form of output equation of DC machine PA will be equal to C naught D square L into L, L into N, and wherein n is in RPS, okay? And C naught is pi square b average ac into 10 to the power minus. Another form of or alternative expression for power developed in the armature will depends upon whether the machine is of low capacity machine or high capacity machine. Suppose if the machine is of high capacity machine, then we will be neglecting the friction and windage and iron losses of the machine, because as compared to the capacity of the machine, this friction, windage and iron losses of the machine will be very very small. So in high capacity machine, we will be neglecting the friction, windage and iron losses of the machine. So that we can say this P is the output of the machine, eta is the efficiency of the machine. So in such cases of high capacity machine, if it is a generator, we can simply say that this PA will be equal to P by eta, and for motor, this PA will be considered as P. Okay, so this is one thing we have to keep it in mind, because it will be applied in solving the problems. We are going to neglect this friction, windage and iron losses of high capacity machines. But in small capacity machines, that is in case of small machines, the friction, windage and iron losses can be taken as 1/3 of the total losses. Suppose what is total losses? It is input power, difference between input power and output power. So input power is P by eta, that is output power by efficiency, minus output power is P. So from here we are getting, and the total, this friction, windage and iron losses are considered 1/3 of this power, 1/3 of this losses. So here 1/3 of losses, that is P into 1 minus eta by eta, is considered as friction, windage and iron losses. So the power developed in the armature of a small machine, hence it is considered as P, that is output power P plus this friction, windage and iron losses. So on reducing this equation, we will be getting this equation. So this equation for a motor and this equation for a generator, because in a motor output power, armature power developed is to overcome the friction, windage and iron losses and then the output power. But in a generator, we are rotating the machine, so input power minus friction and windage losses is going to be the power developed in the armature. So this is the power stage. From the power stage, we are giving this concept, okay? So in a generator, we are applying the input power to the machine, so that first friction, windage and iron losses will be there. The remaining is the power developed in the armature. So input power will be equal to friction, windage and iron losses plus the power developed in the armature. But in a generator, power developed in the armature is we are applying in a motor. So power developed in a motor is, and we are applying only electrical power. So this power developed in the armature is output power plus friction, windage and iron losses. At the last stage only, the friction and windage losses will be there. Only after the motor getting started, this friction, windage and iron losses will take place. So these two concepts are derived from the power stages of the induction machine. So this is another form of equation for a DC machine, that is PA will be equal to, for a small DC motor, P into 1 plus 2 eta by 3 eta, where eta is the efficiency of the machine, and power developed in the armature of a DC generator of small capacity is P into 2 plus eta by 3 eta. So these two are the equations will be used in solving the problem. Suppose if it is a small capacity machine. But if it is a high capacity machine, this iron friction and windage losses will be considered absent, that is negligible, and so the remaining equation will be for PA will be equal to P for motor, and PA will be equal to P by eta for a generator. Okay, and so in today's video lecture, we have discussed about the construction of DC machine, and two equations we have discussed for total electric loading and total magnetic loading, and two more expressions for specific magnetic loading and specific electric loading, and then output equation of DC machine in two forms. So one is PA, that is to separate out this D square M, and another equation to calculate this PA of the machine. After finding out this PA, we will be substituting in this main dimension equation to find out this D square M. So this PA, from this equation we will be finding out PA for a small capacity machine and high capacity machine. Okay, thank you for listening.